car of the 2014 Phillip Island Classic. It's one of the biggest classic races in the world. Huge event. We've got riders here from all over the world, motorcyclists from all over the world. And the Premier Class here is the International Challenge, where we're racing basically a pre-1982 model superbike, putting out similar horsepower to a current CBR 1000 Fireblade, so 160, 170 horsepower, trying to get that in a chassis that was designed for a bike that's producing 80 or 90 horsepower. So very exciting bikes to ride. We saw some thrilling racing yesterday, two events yesterday where the top three or four only finished by a fraction of a second. So we should be in some really good racing today. This machine here is a Honda. The boys have just finished building this. This is a replica of the RS1000 factory Honda machine. And this is being ridden by Mal Campbell. Mal Campbell's an Australian racing legend. He's raced world championship. He's won Bathurst. He's won countless Australian championships. With a bike like this, it's absolutely just old school racing. Basic engine, fueling's done by just carburetors. No sensors, no additional electronics, very, very basic. You know, the way you control it is with the hand on the throttle. So, very challenging to ride, because as I said, we've got a lot of horsepower out of them. The chassis has nowhere near the rigidity of a modern bike chassis, so where modern superbikes hold a line like they're on a rail, these really are bucking and twisting in the middle and fighting us all the way. So, quite thankful the race is only six laps long, to be honest. I find it really satisfying to ride a machine like this, because you are really riding the motorbike. There's no electronic interference, there's nothing between you and the bike. It's just the bare basics. I think that's the reason why myself and all the guys involved really enjoy stepping back onto riding these classic superbikes. The International Challenge has teams from Australia, New Zealand, America, the UK, and the five fastest riders for each country in the qualifying going in a bat for their country. And it's an accumulation of points. So we're not only racing it for ourselves, but for Australia, so to speak, which on Australia Day is a pretty cool thing.